Hello everyone, this is Alex. Today, I will show you how to integrate various tangent functions on the screen easily and quickly. To tackle these four integrals, there are three key facts we need to know. First, the trigonometric identity, 1 plus tangent square x is secant square x. Second, the integral of box to the power of n times box prime is box to the power of n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c. Lastly, the integral of box prime over box is ln modulus box plus c. If you are new to my channel, the second and third facts might seem unfamiliar. For more detailed explanation and examples, check the link at the top right corner. Let me briefly explain. For instance, consider the integral of negative 4x squared plus 3 to the power of 5 times x dx. If you find the derivative of negative 4x squared plus 3 right after negative 4x squared plus 3 to the power of 5, which is negative 8x, then the integration becomes straightforward. However, since negative 8 doesn't appear in the original problem, we divide the integral expression by negative 8. Now, if you see the pattern of the certain power of a term multiplied by its derivative, you can use the following formula for quick integration. All you need to do is multiply by negative 1 over 8, plug in the yellow box, negative 4x squared plus 3, and the green box prime, negative 8x for the derivative, setting it to the same value as in the problem, which is 5. Apply the same process to the right side with n equals to 5, and inserting the yellow box with the same term, negative 4x squared plus 3, and the answer simplifies to negative 4x squared plus 3 to the power of 6 over 6 plus c. This method makes the integration process efficient and easy. To explain the third property that I mentioned earlier, let's look at a simple fraction integral, the integral of negative x over 4x squared plus 3. If the numerator is in the form of the derivative of the denominator, quick integration is possible. The derivative of the denominator, 4x squared plus 3, is 8x, and we need this 8x in the numerator. However, the problem is that the original expression had a minus sign, and 8 did not exist. So we divided the expression by negative 8. Now, bringing the third formula mentioned earlier and comparing it with the problem, we see that we need to multiply the expression by negative 1 over 8, put 8x in the green box prime, and 4x squared plus 3 in the yellow box. Now, we just need to fill in the right box to get the answer, and put 4x squared plus 3 in the yellow box to easily complete the solution. Now, let's use these three facts to solve problems. The first problem is the integral of tangent x dx. Tangent x can be expressed as sine x over cosine x, and when we express this way, the problem becomes the integral of a fraction. Since a fraction integral has come up, what should we do first? We should check if the numerator is in the form of the derivative of the denominator, right? If we differentiate the denominator cosine x, we get negative sine x. So by adding a minus sign to the numerator, we achieve the desired form. However, since we introduced a minus sign that wasn't originally there, let's multiply the entire expression by another minus sign outside the integral symbol. Now, bringing back the third formula we discussed earlier, multiplying it by the added minus sign, and we put negative sine x in the green box prime. Finally, just put cosine x in the yellow box of the denominator, and the answer is negative ln modulus cosine x plus c. The second problem we will tackle is the integral of tangent square x. Previously, we mentioned the identity 1 plus tangent square x is secant square x. If you rearrange it for tangent square x, we get secant square x minus 1. Substituting this into the expression, we have the integral of secant square x minus 1 dx, which can be expanded into an integral of secant square x dx minus integral of 1 dx. Ultimately, the answer is tangent x minus x plus c, as we know that the integral of secant square x is just tangent x. Now, let's move on to the third problem, the integral of tangent cubed x dx. If we factor tangent cubed x into tangent x and tangent square x, and we use the tangent square x as secant square x minus 1 identity we introduced earlier, the integral becomes tangent x times secant square x minus 1 dx. Expanding the brackets and expressing each integral separately, we have the integral of tangent x times secant square x dx minus integral of tangent x dx. However, We already found the result for the integral of tangent x dx in the first problem, which is ln modulus cosine x plus c. Now, let's revisit the formula we introduced earlier. Comparing with the problem, we see the yellow box corresponds to tangent x with n equals 1, and the green box prime should have secant square x since it's derivative of tangent x. Now, for the right side, we put tangent x in the yellow box, and n is again 1. Therefore, the integral result is tangent square x over 2 plus c. Adding up the two integrals we found, it will be tangent square x over 2 minus bracket minus ln modulus cosine x plus c. And the final result is tangent square x over 2 plus ln modulus cosine x plus c after a bit of a simplification. Now, let's tackle the last problem, the integral of tangent x to the power 4. Expressing tangent x to the power 4 as the product of two tangent square x terms, we get the integral of tangent square x times tangent square x dx. Similar to the previous problems, let's utilize tangent square x as secant square x minus 1. By substituting secant square x minus 1 for the second tangent square x, the integral becomes tangent square x times secant square x minus 1 dx. Expanding the brackets and expressing each integral separately, we have the integral of tangent square x times secant square x dx minus integral of tangent square x dx. The second integral is already familiar to us from the earlier solution of tangent x minus x plus c, so we'll use that result. Now, for the first integral, let's bring back the box rule formula and compare with the problem. Do you see it? In the yellow box, we put tangent x and the exponent n becomes 2, right? Similarly, we place the n on the right side with 2. The green box prime should have secant square x, the derivative of the yellow box. Now, for the right yellow box, we put tangent x again, and the answer is tangent cube x over 3 plus c. Therefore, the integral of tangent x to the power 4 is tangent cube x over 3 minus bracket tangent x minus x plus c. And when we expand the brackets, it becomes tangent cube x over 3 minus tangent x plus c. Even as the degree of tangent x increases, we can integrate using the methods we've been employed today. We've integrated tangent functions from the first to the fourth degree using the trigonometric identity and two instances of the box rule. I have more videos on various box rule integrations on my channel, so feel free to check them out. If you found today's video helpful, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. This has been your Math Guardian, Alex.